welcome to Gospel Music USA. My name is Danny Jones. I'm with Singing News Magazine.
I'm Karen Peck Gooch with Karen Peck and New River.
And I'm Mike Lefevre with the Lefevre Quartet. And if you're looking forward to some great gospel music, then you're at the right place.
That's
You are. And today, gang, we are going to do something just a little bit different from our normal format. Now, the group that's with us, Johnny Minnick and the Stewart Brothers, this will be your first introduction for many of you to this group. And they have a very special flair with their style of gospel music. So now we want to take you back, say, to the early 40s or so, when Western music was still at the forefront of everybody's mind. So ladies and gentlemen, sit back and enjoy Johnny Minnick and the Stewart Brothers.
My heart can see when I pause to remember a heartache here is but a stepping stone along the trail that's winding always upward. This troubled world is not my final goal. But until then, my heart will go on singing. Until then, with joy.
Down his hand. When he came to me there, and he told me that I could be free. Oh, he lifted my feet and he gave me joy so complete when he reached up.
Hey everyone, welcome back to Gospel Music USA. Our guest today, Johnny Minnick and the Stewart Brothers. And if you're sitting there at home right now looking at your TV set thinking, boy, one of those guys looks very familiar. Do not adjust your set. That is Johnny Minnick. You probably remember him from Goodman Revival. He is active in both groups. And now, Johnny, you need to tell us about Johnny Minnick and the Stewart Brothers.
Actually, I've known these guys longer than I've known the Goodmans.
Really?
Yeah. When I was 14, I had a little group where I grew up in Little Rock. And Phil started coming to our church and wrangled him into singing tenor in my little group.
You said wrangled because you got on you.
That's right. I try to use
that
wrangler stuff. Yeah. I caught that.
We're impressed.
Thank you.
And then he brought his brother into the group. Lonnie.
He lassoed him in.
He lassoed him in. Yeah. Oh, good. You got it now.
Okay, don't laugh. I'll keep doing it.
Okay. So. Yeah, don't boot her.
So that was back in the 70s, and yeah. I've known these guys for a long, long time. We've covered most of the United States in our travels as far as our career is concerned. Phil pastored in the Bay Area, San Francisco, for 28 years.
Wow.
Lonnie's been a rancher and raised horses, and he's the only real cowboy we got.
He can wear tennis shoes and be a cowboy.
Yeah. Really? Oh, wow. In Arkansas?
Texas.
Oh, in Texas.
California.
Oh,
yeah, that's official
wow.
When you're Texas friend.
Well, yeah. So where are you all based out? Are you still based out of those places, or are you?
No. I was still pastoring full-time.
In Tennessee,
and I needed an associate pastor, and I called Phil about, what was it, six years ago? Yeah.
Wow.
And he left California and came to Smyrna, where I was pastor.
Smyrna, Tennessee. Mm-hmm.
And he always brings his brother.
Oh, isn't that neat? I love that.
So we started singing again, and we've all always loved Western music. And it died back in the 60s.
Right. You know,
it got swallowed up.
Western music really had a good run, let's say in the late 30s, 1940s, even into the 50s. Mm-hmm. And then country separated itself from Western, if mm-hmm. you will.
Yeah.
And the Western aspect of country music sort of fell by the wayside.
It did.
Right.
But there is some very intricate harmonies involved in Western music.
There is.
Some sounds you just don't get anywhere else. So what was the catalyst for taking that classic Western sound, mixing it with classic gospel songs? What brought it all together?
Well, we just wanted to be a little different than everybody else in the pond, you know. We all share the same music that we get from church and things like that. So we just wanted ours to sound a little different. And as much as we loved Western music, we thought if we could marry Western and gospel, what would that sound like? So we thought we'd find out.
I will say this,
did
it's
it well.
Working.
Did
it is working well. I am so impressed. I had not heard the group until today.
Really?
And so I heard that you what you were doing, but y'all, your blend is so well. And but you have to keep the shirts and the and the ties, the handkerchiefs. Bandanas, you have to keep that in the act as well, because that, honestly, it's really good. Well, so I think you're getting a lot of great response,
we
though,
are.
Aren't you?
It's been good everywhere we've gone.
All right, so let's talk about this. Obviously, with the love for the Western music, when you were growing up, were your heroes cowboys? Did you spend a lot of time watching the Westerns and things like that? Now, as I get older, I like Westerns on TV. Oh, yeah. I mean, I just do.
Yeah.
And is that something that you grew up, and is that just part of what's ingrained in you?
Well, I've always enjoyed the movies. I know these guys can speak for themselves. Yeah. But musically, I love people like Elmer Bernstein that wrote Magnificent Seven, and people who, and my background is actually classical music, if you can believe that or not. I was raised, trained as a classical piano player. That was before Happy Goodman's.
That's
so incredible. The first time they heard me play, I was a classical piano player. And I've loved orchestrations and people who could write for orchestra. So I always loved the music aspect of the big Westerns.
Okay.
And
who produced this album that you've got?
I did.
So you produced it. Mm-hmm. And we were just commenting, Mike was commenting on the strings and the orchestration, and that's beautiful.
It's a great blend.
Yeah, it is. Are y'all having the time of your lives?
We're just enjoying a good time.
Yeah, is that better than being on the ranch?
I don't know.
Even better than that, is it better than being in California?
Yeah. No, we had a lot of fun, love the reactions of the folks out in the audience when we start singing.
I bet.
That's exactly what I was about to ask.
Sing all our songs.
What is the reaction when you come out and you start that first song? Does the entire audience almost just start reliving their memories
You see everybody in the audience starting
red
to
eyes,
sing.
Oftentimes they're singing with us.
Have you taken this to California yet?
Yeah.
Yes.
Embracing?
Oh, yeah. Well, where Lonnie and I were raised is the Midwest of California, the Central Valley. So a lot of our family and friends grew up with this kind of music. And our uncle sang and played bass for Bob Wills and the Texas Playboys back in the 40s.
Well, there is Western right there for you. If anybody knows it, that group did. All right, very quickly, how do we find out more about Johnny Minnick and the Stewart Brothers? Where do we go online?
You can go to Johnny Minnick and Stewart Brothers. com. What's our other address? Do you remember?
It's all Johnny Minnick and the Stewart Brothers, but you can Google it, and you'll get way more than you need.
YouTube. There's some videos out there.
All right, folks, go to your computer right now. Google these guys. Find out more about what they're doing and their music. I promise you, you will love every single second of it. Come back in just a few moments. We're going to sing a few more songs for you right here on Gospel Music USA.
Welcome back to Gospel Music USA. And today we have on the show Johnny Minnick and the Stewart Brothers. Now, Johnny is the producer of the group as well, but what we're hearing is the original soundtrack to one of the old classics. And you produced this as well, didn't you, Johnny?
I did, Karen, and we're dressed this way on purpose because this is a Western themed song.
Yes, and I think it's very appropriate. You have to wear the Western attire.
We do.
That's for sure. Now, we hope that all of you will be blessed by this. I can't wait to hear this. The old classic, I Am Bound for the Promised Land.
On Jordan's stormy banks I stand and cast a wistful eye to Canaan's fair and happy land where my possessions lie. I am bound for the promised land, bound for the promised land. Oh, who will come and go with me? I am bound for the promised land.
O'er all those wide extended plains shines one eternal day. There God the sun forever reigns and scatters night away.
I am bound for the promised land, bound for the promised land. Oh, who will come and go with me? I am bound for the promised land. When I shall reach that happy place, I'll be forever blessed. For I shall see my Father's face and in His bosom. I know. just a closer walk.
How
closer walk with me. Pray it, Jesus is my plea.
And the Stewart brothers, that was great. Good, good job. Hey, listen, now, proof positive that gospel music can be done in many, many styles.
That's
we've,
true.
You know, on this program, we've had quartets, family groups, trios, soloists, duets. We've had it all. But I can honestly say this is the first time we've had a group bring a Western flair, and you guys did it very, very well. Good job. Good
well,
job.
Thank you.
Now, one more time, how can our viewers find out more about this group?
Well, we can send them to Johnny Minnick and the Stewart Brothers. You can Google that name, and it'll bring you to several different places. YouTube, we have an Instagram page, Amazon, different places that they can find us,
so
find our music.
So in other words, you are everywhere.
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 iTunes, everywhere.
Okay, well, now, in the coming months, what are some of the highlights that you will look back on and say 2 years from now, say 2019 was a great year for us because?
Well, there's some good television shows.
There you go. Good start.
One here,
good start.
Yeah. Yes. I understand that we'll be doing the Ray Stevens show and possibly some other ones there in Nashville.
Wow. So you got a full year planned already.
We do, yeah.
That's great.
Yeah.
Well, I tell you what, now. For those viewers who have a little life experience on them, they're going to certainly remember the days of the 50s and the 40s and the mm-hmm. 30s when Western music really was king. And I tell you what, just for those folks, do you have one more classic gospel song you can blend in with that classic Western flair? All right, ladies and gentlemen, you may welcome one final time today here on Gospel Music USA, Johnny Minnick and the Stewart Brothers.
Thank you, David.
I wandered so aimless, life filled with sin. I wouldn't let my dear Savior in. Then Jesus came like a stranger in the night. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw the light. I saw the light.